everywhere, and I feel blessings in the air. Those seeds that you've sown, you're gonna come into your own. Seeds, walk into your seeds. Oh, I feel them.
Seasons everywhere.
Yes, I do. Said I feel them, young
blessings in the air.
Those seeds that you sow, it's time to come into your own. Seeds,
walk into your seeds.
I believe we're in a time when God's gonna bless.
All right, I'm here talking with our very first member, Sister Wanda Smith. Just talk to us freely about any memories that you have back when we were on 1700 Knowles Street at Greater Hebrew. Can you recall when we first met or some things there?
Yes, when we first met, Pastor wanted to change the name. Of course, I got upset. I said, who does this man come here to change the name? It was three members of the church. Two had left, and I stayed. Two stayed at first, and then myself and another member. And then after a while, the other member left to go with her husband to his ministry. Pastor came in, and he talked, and I liked the way he expressed himself very well. He was very articulate, and he knew his Bible. So many things the pastor had asked to do around the church, and me being the only stubborn member there, I was like objective to it. But pastor finally brought my mind to it. He wanted to actually change the name of the church, because after teaching, he taught us what the name actually meant to the church, which it was a Baptist church, and now I'm Pentecostal. I've learned a lot more from pastor.
A lot of people don't understand our relationship.
Okay.
They don't. But they don't know we are so close.
Yes, we are.
We are very close, and you've always been near and dear to my heart. And I think there are two things that stand out in my mind.
Okay.
It took from 2000 to 2004 before I remember our connection, our first real connection.
Okay.
Happened in 2004. You were working in the church and you were coming and everything, but I can recall preaching in 2004, and I walked back to the back of the church on Knoll Street, which my office was in the back
in the
left hand side, that is now
right.
A bathroom.
Right.
But I remember you were standing back there ushering, and you said, I could call you my pastor now.
Oh, you remember
because,
that.
Because you never would call me your pastor. Right. But what took place for you to, after 4 years, say, okay,
pastor,
I'll accept you?
I don't know, Pastor. I think it was more listening to what you were preaching. You taught me that the love that you had was not just in the words of the Bible. It was for people. And people that felt like they didn't deserve the love. It was more to the fact that you, no matter what I said, what I done, you had a smile on your face and shook your head and said, okay, Sister Smith. And you go away, you pray about it, you come back again, and you just kept chipping and chipping and chipping and chipping that hardness away from me. And you were the only one that smiled all the time. And you still smile and just say, okay, Sister Smith. Anybody else would have gave up on me years ago because they say, well, she just mean, no, Sister Smith, not me. Just give her time. That's all you say. Just give her time. Give her patience. Leave Sister Smith alone. Just let Sister Smith be. And I got to thinking, I said, well, maybe he's working on Sister Smith. And you always smile. That's what really got it, is you smiled a lot. And you took me to the Word. I thought I knew the Word, but I didn't know until I really met you. I mean, really met you, and knowing that You was true to your word. You stayed in the word. You didn't do like all the other ministers that we followed. You go to the word. You stayed there. You didn't transfer off and lived one way and then preached another. But that's another story. But yeah. That's what really made me say I could call you my pastor. Because you really hung in there, and I didn't think you were going to stay. I'm going to tell you the truth. I didn't think you were going to stay, but you
well,
stayed.
Well, I'm glad that the Lord called me. I'm committed to you because you didn't have to be committed to me. You could have very well said, I don't know anything about you.
Right.
I'm going with my mom or my dad, and I figured if you could trust me and give me a chance, I needed to trust you and give you a chance.
All right.
And that's why I love you.
I
and
love
we'll always be close.
I'll always be having close.
All right.
I love you.
All right. And this ain't just for the camera. I love you.
I love you too, Pam.
Praise the Lord, saints of C.O.J.C. I am so honored to say hello to all of you. I miss all of you. And I just want to say one of the things that I learned from Pastor Matthew's First Lady and the Church of Jesus Christ is that you have to dig into God's word until it starts digging in you. If it had not been for C.O.J.C. while I was in Asheville, I would not have been introduced to God. So I just want to tell you all, thank you. You are so very blessed. And if I had one word to describe you all, it would be amazing. I love you all, and I'll see you soon.
That you've invested a lot, but the return has been slow. You throw up your hands and say, I give up. I just can't take it anymore.